When you create auto-scheduled tasks, you name the task and fill in duration, and project takes care of the rest. We're going to add some auto-scheduled tasks to this project. The first thing we're going to do is change the task mode to auto-scheduled. That's usually what you want. Go down to the status bar at the bottom of the project window, and it says new tasks are manually scheduled. We'll click that and then choose auto-scheduled. That way, project can calculate dates and durations for you. Now that we've done that, let's go up to the task table and click the first blank task name cell. I'm going to type in the task name, move to new office, and press tab to go to the duration cell. A few things happen. First of all, the task mode is set to auto-scheduled. You can see that it's a blue bar with a right-pointing arrow. Next, the duration cell says 1 day question mark. Project fills this in. It's a default estimated value. That's what the question mark means. Finally, the start date is based on the start date for the summary task that this task belongs to. Over in the time scale, you see a task bar that's 1 day long, and it's blue to indicate that it's auto-scheduled. Now let's go to the duration cell and put in the estimate for the move. So I think it's going to take 5 days, so I type in 5D and press tab. When I do that, the task bar in the time scale changes its length to be 5 days. In addition, that changes the finish date. Now let's create another auto-scheduled task. This time, I'm going to insert it into the existing list. I'm going to right-click row 6 for repair issues, and then choose Insert Task. That inserts the task above repair issues. The task name cell is selected, so I can go right ahead and type the name for this task. Let's say it's prep walls. When I press tab, I go to the duration cell. Again, it's 1 day question mark, the default estimated duration. I'm going to type in 2D for 2 days and press tab. When I do that, project calculates the finish date. The start date is based on the start date of the summary task. That's all it takes to create auto-scheduled tasks.